Bienvenue à Los Angeles. Dans cette vidéo, nous avons parlé à certains résidents qui ont vu des changements dans la communauté, grande ou petite, et leur a demandé de partager leurs réflexions et leurs expériences. Voici ce que certains d'entre eux ont inventé à dire.
I used to live in Pomona, California. I don't live there anymore, but I used to live there, and I lived there from the age of 4 to the age of 25. When I was a baby, they put me in West Covina. After 25, I moved to Chino Hills, and then recently, I moved to Brea.
My family moved to Dunbar in 65. We stayed 78, so that's 13 years. And during my first marriage, I lived just about half a mile away from here, also in the Baltimore side, for another 12 years. So it's about 25 years in the city of Baltimore.
Pomona, about 33 years.
I guess I'm glad that we're more community-centered and more neighborhood watch and looking out for each other. That's a good thing. They do miss kind of the idea that I grew up with a whole bunch of kids on my street, and that doesn't seem to be the case in my neighborhood anymore for the kids that there are.
Phillips Ranch was a fairly new community. Not brand new, but fairly new community. And it was very green.
Oh.
They tell me, like, when Diamond Ranch used to not be here, it used to just be like a big green hill, and then when it would rain, there's like a tiny little like waterfall even from this hill. So they said it was really pretty. I noticed there's like a lot of parks, community involvement. So right across from my parents' house is the green belt through Phillips Ranch. And so like you can go and play, and you have like two big backyards, so the park's your backyard, or playing soccer growing up at Decker Park or at cross something park up by Ranch Hill. So they had a lot of parks. Unfortunately, I feel like they've changed in terms of being not industrial, but like having more businesses. I feel like a lot of businesses have closed in Pomona, except for this recent opening of like the Target down there by Rio Rancho. Like and all that stuff. But there's that whole, like, there used to be by Decker a supermarket and a Rite Aid and an Ace Hardware and like two or three different hair salons and restaurants and, you know, a bunch of stuff. And that was all there when I was a kid, and they slowly closed one by one.
Biggest changes obviously is the increase in population. When I first moved to Dime Bar, it was a very, very small town. I was one of the first 500 residents when we moved there in 1965. There was no freeway access. You had to do grocery shopping. You had to go down Fifth Avenue, which is now Colima, and into Walnut Heights. And if you wanted to go to get fast food, the closest you could go. So I've seen a lot of change. The freeway coming in was a huge impact. One of the biggest changes I saw has been the increased amount of diversity. Dunbar, when I first lived there, was your typical 1950s, 1960s white flight city, where the city was like 99.9% Anglo. But fortunately, that has changed over time, and there's a lot more diversity there now. You know, I was always a big fan of the hats, and I love trying to get away from eating that way. This is a good group.
Pop culture isn't just a fashion, it's a way of life. Hollywood, the City of Angels, Rodeo Drive, The Hills, everyone wants to be in the limelight. Ice Cube, Dre, Easy, Yella, and Rain forming the most dangerous group to keep in the Kardashians. Sports have always been a relevant aspect of that. Lakers. Dodgers. Clippers. Angels. Kings. Ducks. Galaxy. Rams. Chargers. We love our sports. Like Tupac said, I love LA.